In the last video, we covered the tributaries of the superior vena cava and the brachiocephalic veins. Now, let's go ahead and follow these veins as we cover the veins of the upper limb. So in this video, we're gonna cover the veins of the upper limb by first going through the subclavian vein, then the axillary vein, and then cover the deep system of veins in the arm, followed by the superficial system of veins in the arm. So the easiest way to understand the veins of the systemic circulation is to divide them into their own systems. The veins of the heart form their own system. We have the veins of the inferior vena cava, which is responsible for supplying the lower half of the body. We have the veins of the superior vena cava for the upper half of the body, and the portal system, which drain nutrition from intestines and waste products from the spleen and dump them into the liver to be processed, which then lead the blood into the inferior vena cava again. So these are the four main system of veins we have in our body. Let's now talk briefly about the venous drainage of the upper limb, starting with the subclavian vein. The first thing you need to remember is that the brachiocephalic vein is formed by a union of the subclavian vein and the internal jugular vein. Alright, let's go ahead and zoom in and start covering the subclavian vein. As the subclavian vein passes the first rib, it passes within a groove called the groove for the subclavian vein. Now the subclavian vein has only minor tributaries, as most of the veins following the branches of the subclavian artery open into either the brachiocephalic vein or the internal jugular vein. So the one that drains into the subclavian vein is the dorsal scapular vein, which drains the area supplied by the dorsal scapular artery, like the levator scapula, the rhomboids, and the trapezius. And it also receives blood from the external jugular vein, which remember has tributaries like the anterior jugular vein and the suprascapular vein and the transverse cervical vein. So that was the subclavian vein. Now let's go ahead and cover the axillary vein. The axillary vein starts at the border of the teres major muscle and ends at the subclavian vein, like this. Its tributaries correspond with the branches of the axillary artery, like the thoracoepigastric vein, the lateral thoracic vein, the anterior circumflex humeral vein, and the posterior circumflex humeral vein. But it also has tributaries that are special for the axillary vein, like the cephalic vein. Let's now go ahead and zoom out and draw a layout of how the veins of the arms are arranged. So again, the subclavian vein has the external jugular vein and the dorsal scapular vein draining into it. Then there's the axillary vein, which has the anterior and the posterior circumflex humeral veins, the lateral thoracic and the thoracoepigastric veins, as well as the cephalic vein. Awesome. So the veins of the upper limb form two systems. There's the deep system of veins and the superficial system of veins. The main deep veins we're going to cover are the brachial veins, ulnar veins, radial veins, and the deep venous palmar arch. While the superficial veins we're going to cover are the basilic, cephalic, median cubital, intercapitular, and the dorsal venous network of the hand. Let's now start with the deep system of the veins first. Now the veins of the deep system follow the course of the arteries. Two veins accompany each artery up until the armpit. So first are the two brachial veins that go from the axillary vein to the cubital area. It then continues as two radial veins going towards the right side of the wrist. Then there's the ulnar veins that drain either to the radial vein or the ulnar veins. These veins form the collateral veins of the elbow, just like the arteries do, and they do that through veins like the inferior ulnar collateral and the superior ulnar collateral veins, as well as veins like the deep brachial vein and the radial recurrent veins. So these four are considered a part of the collateral veins of the elbow. Then we have the deep venous palmar arch, which drains the fingers and the metacarpals, and then dump the blood into the deep veins. So that was a quick walkthrough for the deep system of veins. Now, let's go ahead and cover the superficial veins of the upper limb. The superficial system lies superficially to the fascia of the muscles and lack corresponding arteries. So the first one that we're going to talk about is the basilic vein. Now the basilic vein goes like this. It arises at the dorsal venous network of the hand and courses on the medial side of the forearm and then runs on the medial bicipital groove in the arm, and then joins the brachial veins. Then we have the basilic vein, which arises at the dorsal venous network of the hand as well. And then it courses on the lateral side of the forearm and runs in the lateral bicipital groove in the arm and then joins the axillary vein. Then we have the median cubital vein, which connects the cephalic vein with the basilic vein across the cubital fossa. And sometimes between the cephalic and the basilic vein, you will find the median antebrachial vein. Then we have the superficial venous palmar arch, which lies below the palmar aponeurosis and the arterial arch. This one drains into the superficial and the deep veins. Then we have the dorsal venous network of the hand, which is a venous network on the dorsum of the hand, and it gives rise to veins such as the cephalic vein and the basilic vein, as you see here. Then lastly, we have the intercapitular veins, which are veins that form connections draining the venous blood from the palm to the dorsal venous network of the hand. So that was everything I had for the venous drainage of the upper limb. And with that, my friends, we finally covered all the veins of the superior vena cava. The next couple of videos are going to be about the inferior vena cava and the portal system.